Hi there, St. Paul's family. Thanks for tuning in today. I'm going to try something a little bit different with our time here this week, and I just want to kind of give you an update on some things that are coming up in our congregation, especially this weekend as we look ahead to our Sunday time together. Before we get there, tomorrow night there's youth group and Bible study and kids club, and I'm excited for that. Next week too, by the way, we're going to start Bible 102, and that's a second class for adults. And so if that's something that you'd be interested in taking part in, please contact myself or Jeremy Larson for more information. You are welcome, invited to attend that class. It's going to be going over a lot of the foundations of the Christian faith and digging in a little bit deep into what we believe and why we believe it. In the meantime, though, we have stuff tomorrow night, starting with Hebrews chapter 2. That's where the adult Bible study is going to be. I'm going to be in the youth room, and that's why I'm here today in this video. I'm going to be leading our youth in a Bible study on Ephesians chapter 1, and I'm excited to bring that message to them. It's from the second part of chapter 1, after Paul has just explained all these characteristics of who we are as Christians. We are redeemed, we are blessed, we are predestined, we are heirs of heaven, we are sealed in Christ, and what a hope that gives us. And he says, for this reason, I thank God and for you. And he says, and I pray that the eyes of your heart might be opened to see just how great and wonderful, merciful, mighty, awesome, loving God is for you, and that you would be filled with those things. That's what Paul prays for here in Ephesians 1. And it got me thinking about the sermon here coming up on Sunday too. I'm going to talk about how the congregation is alive and the life that we have. In 1 John 5, John says that he who has the Son has life. And so we're going to look at the life that we have in Jesus and how joyful and wonderful it is because of all these things that we have, the riches that we have in Jesus Christ. And so come out on Sunday if you're able to. It's Communion Sunday also. And so be ready for that. Be thinking about that. We're looking forward to sharing that that meal together as the body of Christ. If you can't be here, you're welcome to tune in on our live stream too. I'm so thankful how that continues to be used by so many of you here through these days and weeks and months. And so, hope to see you either here on Sunday or to have you join us on the live stream. God bless your week.